first time you enter his dojo, you have to climb up these stairs. And then once I first stepped foot on the second floor, they were practicing, seeing Abe Sensei in front of you.
Abe Sensei was fascinating. He was a real role model, you might say. I speak only dojo Japanese and very little at that. But he was able to teach Kokyo and the techniques that he taught without language.
Well, he's very small, first of all. There's something kind of a little bit ethereal about him in his persona, but he was more approachable than I would have imagined having, you know, prior to meeting him.
And the purpose of this trip, the first, I wanted to introduce my mentor to my students.
Yeah. I mean, this practice is...
Abe Sensei is O Sensei's calligraphy teacher, and he's a disciple of Ueshiba Morihei Sensei. Almost 2 months before O Sensei passed away, until then, O Sensei used to come to Abe Sensei's house every single month, and he stayed about 1 week to 10 days. I decided to follow Abe Sensei. Abe Sensei is my mentor. And I want to introduce my mentor to my students. And continuously, I want to learn, see. First time I met Abe Sensei, I believe 1977. I participated one of Abe Sensei's seminars. When I was 19 years old. I just graduated from high school, and he appeared. And I remember he was showing his hara, you know, lower abdomen, and he was explaining importance of kokyu and breathing. That was really first time I believe I met Abe Sensei on the mat. Unfortunately, there are many people, and there are many my senpai there, and all of them took Abe Sensei's ukemi. I didn't have opportunity to even touch his hand. Very unfortunate, you know, that time. But very impressed. Very impressed. I was always, you know, thinking about, you know, his technique, his explanation of spirituality and kokyu and his calligraphy. But really, until I came to this country and previous teacher, he invited him, I believe 1984, November. And until then, I really didn't get knowing him. And very fortunately, I was the only one who spoke Japanese at that time, and I was a senior student at that time. I had a great opportunity to take care of Abe Sensei for about 10 days, about nearly 2 weeks, I believe. And first time I took his ukemi, all of his seminars. And very fortunately, I had the opportunity, finally. And I didn't understand when he asked me to grab his hand tightly, more tight, you know, as hard as you can. Oh, every time I grabbed his hand, I went down, on the mat, fall down. Every time I grabbed and I fall down, I didn't understand why. I didn't understand. And one time I felt without touching, and I went down. And that was fascinating. And since then, I was curious and wondering, and I wanted to learn more. And 91, I myself invited him to this country. And I introduced him to my student. First time I introduced Shodo, what Shodo is, and Abe Sensei. And then next year, I remember 92, we made Japan tour. We went to see Abe Sensei. and everybody inspired. And then again, I invited him in 93 and 94. He came in 94 with his students. But I remember 13 students came together with him. So we had a great friendship seminar with Japanese people. And under Abe Sensei, we learned calligraphy and Aikido and Kokyu and Kojiki lecture. I prepared everything. The more I invite him and more people, my people involved, inspired. So actually several people went to Japan by themselves since then, like Carlos, Steve, and Sean, and many people.
The first time I went to Japan, and I was still maybe 8-10 years ago, I'd say in 94-95. So the experience is a little overwhelming initially because you're kind of grabbing or attacking 85, 90 year old gentleman, and at first you're hesitant because you feel maybe you're going to hurt him or something like that, but actually quickly it becomes the other way around, so you don't worry about him as much as you worry about yourself. And when he wants to, he can throw very hard, and other times he throws very, very, very soft. And I was at his dojo, and he gave me the opportunity to attack him as hard as I could. And I remember sitting in Seizal and jumping up to attack him. And as soon as I had gotten up, I was thrown on my knees so hard that my knees were really sore. And I got up again and was slammed down again. And I got up again, slammed down again. And he was doing a minimal technique, but he was also 4 or 5 feet away from me. So that was an amazing experience. It's still hard to believe. I have no idea how he did it. Now if I take his ukeme or I attack Abe Sensei, I'm a lot more careful.
Deepest impression that Abe Sensei have made on me has been that, you know, it's just how generous he is. I mean, as Matsuo Sensei has always said, Abe Sensei's humanity is truly, he's what we aspire to be as humans. And very generous, not only in his time, but in his spirit, in his, you know, wiseness, I guess, if that is the word. And to really be with Abe Sensei, spend time with him, just talking, eating, and just to feel, to be around him. And I was very inspired by that experience. I think any senior students or any students that have the opportunity to go to Japan, I would definitely highly recommend it.
he was talking about relationship between Shodo, calligraphy, and Aikido all the time. I didn't understand at the beginning, but the more he explained, I inspired more. And also, he has a very unique situation with O-sensei. He also taught Shodo to O-sensei. This is one reason O-sensei left so many calligraphies, so many. And I saw, very fortunately, you could see, I agree, everybody. Brush movement in calligraphy and hand movement in Aikido. There's a common point based on the Koki. So that's the theme, Koki. What's Koki? In order to seek Koki, many different ways. Abe-sensei was trying to teach, practice Aikido, develop Koki through handwriting. Abe-sensei told me, O-sensei's Aikido cannot, after he finished movement, it's gone. His ki cannot see. But calligraphy, O-sensei does. After finish calligraphy, so O-sensei's ki is there, exists. Many, many years. So Abe-sensei said, that's why he introduced O-sensei's calligraphy to many people. This is O-sensei's ki, existing still here. In this point, there is Aikido, there is Shodo, and different art, but Shokoku, it's a difficult concept, I'm speaking. Personally, I determined I want to learn his Koku technique, and I want to polish him more and more. He's the one who took care of O-sensei, and he's a great person, wonderful person. I want to introduce my mentor to my students. That's why we made Japan tour, and I direct you continuously make this opportunity. Hopefully, we can bring him here, so that's easier. But I'm concerning his age, so maybe rather than that, maybe we may have more opportunity, you know, to go there to get, you know, guidance and receive training from him. That's my wish, continuously from now on.